Thank you. all probably a discrimination for us. There's always this kind of thing to check on the field and check on the culture factor. But first, this girl is new, and she doesn't work for him. Hey, Thomas, can you pause and come on over here for just a sec? Who is this girl? Where did she come from? And listen to how he describes her for just a second. He says to her, Boaz, if you have to tell me what is the name of this child, you have to come here for this one. Boaz, she said, Moab. If I want to ask you, she's Boaz, that she comes from a land of Boaz, she's not from around here. This girl is not a wild people. And then he says, but I will tell you this, she's here up early in the morning, she's like, please let me go. And gather up the students off of the river, so she can't be exercised. From early in the morning until night, except for short words. This is a hard working walk for us, but she will come. You want to make a difference. You know that there is some strong relationships between Israel and their whole member of the Knesset, but there is a very difficult relationship between Israel and Moab. Because Moab worships the Lord. In fact, Moab, the people of Moab, who was the result of an incestuous relationship between Lot and the gods. And for the people of Israel, it did get any worse than it comes from a husband. And Boaz shows up on the farm and talks with Boaz. The guy says, Boaz, you don't want anything to do with this girl. She's not from around here, but she's from around here. She's from around here. Boaz, don't pay her any money. But he did say this. She's a very, very hard-working woman. And the process, both of them, they describe a woman through the book of Ruth, and here's what they call the book of Ruth. And that's how you get it basically the personification of the daughter's birth. And she's hardworking, she's industrious, she loves Jesus, and she loves her family, and she works her diligence for the success of her family. Now, let's just be brief for just a second. If you have in your Bible, they speak to each other for the first time on the field, but like the angels are singing and the birds are chirping, and it's beautiful, that's not the picture that we're reading about in Luke chapter 10. Ladies, think about it for just a second. She's been in a field all day. She's covered in dirt at the time. Her hair is a mess, her makeup is destroyed, and she is probably nasty and dirty. She probably smells like a football player. I mean, that's how bad this is. And no other woman in the right hand would show up in public looking like Roosevelt, the man that Boaz sees her. But Boaz is interested. That's his offer. He's interested in this woman because of her faith. And clearly, not because of the way. See, Boaz is like him. He's powerful, and he's got a great image, and he's a great image. Boaz could basically find an eligible one anytime in the interview. Boaz becomes very interested in this young woman and becomes interested because of her character. I said it once in a time out of this book. If you're looking for the best kids, please don't make the parents say something out of her because of the way she looks. Because I'm 20, 40, 30, 50 years later, he won't look like that. You will find a woman who has a godly character. She will become more beautiful than 50 years after the day she married. If you will find a woman who has a beautiful soul and a godly character, you will find that that best is a comfort, that best is a better man because of the way she looks. Because Boaz is a man of godly character, he's looking for a woman who has a godly character. I think the woman who has that is that. Because he is also a man who is concerned about other people. Verses 8 and 9 said that you're going to do a good job, you're going to do a man who's concerned about others. Listen to Boaz's statement when he first talks to us. And I'm going to put that conversation to the end. Then Boaz said, now listen to myself. This is a term of protection, by the way, my daughter. He says, listen to my daughter. Listen to my daughter. Don't go and leave me a thousand years to believe this. But keep close to my young one. Let your eyes be on the field that there will be an epilogue to them. has is the responsibility of a lifetime to do something to people. New life is one of the most important things that is the most important thing for all people. And it says that you're only 24/19. When you are forced to hear from you, but you forget to bring up other people in the spirit, and just go back and get it. Thank you. Simon here fell on his face as he bowed to the ground. He said to him, "Why am I a favor in your eyes, Boaz, that you should take notice of me?" And listen to how this refers to himself. Boaz, you have spoken. I'm a boy. I don't deserve these teachings that you're giving me. Please listen for just a second. Boaz is going out this way to study these other biblical teachings. And if this is God, he's interested in you, but he stimulates that it would be right now. Because God is interested in you, and he's showing you a little bit of attention. You have every right like this. So look at his past and say, "Why do you do this? And what's your interest? And where is this benefit?" We call that in total humility the whole focus. He says, "I have deserved this focus. You want this, and I don't deserve it to you. That's your duty." Verse 11, "But Boaz is simply all that you have done. Has been told to him how you love to him, all that you've done for your mother in law since the death of your husband. It's been told to him how you left your father and your mother and your old one, and you take him to a people that you do not know." The Bible says, "See, your reputation goes before you." And people in town are talking about you, Ruth. They're talking about how much you love your mother. They're talking about how much you were willing to do when you left home to go live with this woman with no future. And more importantly, they're talking about your baby. And that's me. But I've heard about your baby. And if I want to reward you, I want to be gracious to you. Because of you are the disrespected God by the church. I would love nothing but that for all the nice times that you have to be here. This guy's never had me before. First time he's seen Jacob, he looks at the Israelites and then prays for their head. He says, verse 12, "What are your names?" "The Lord bless you, the Lord be told you, the Lord be good to you because of what you've done." He takes it a step further and he says, "I think the Lord be good to you, a full reward for what you've done by the God of Israel, by the Lord." And the Bible says, "Because it's under his hand that you want to fulfill the truth of his name, you follow him. You can just go back to that person. You can just stop and get to a relative next day that's been written. You can be from the village protection of the little baby called little, the little baby bird called this book. It's not just me that's protecting you. It's not just my name that's protecting you. You are the Lord's protection. And I've been praying that God would bless you and that God would rejoice for you because of your faith." Because people are talking about you. They're talking about the touch you were willing to lose for the rest of you. And so the Lord knows how it becomes to his own truth. How it becomes the best of all which God would bless you. God would benefit you. God would reward you in ways that you can never possibly imagine. I wonder how many times you've gone to bed praying to God, "I have some friends who are some family, a co-worker, one of my friends and friends that needs to hear about Jesus." And if that's the case, you may be the convenient to that friend. You may be the very one that God wants to walk to the next two and across the street. But go across the middle of the place. The rest of time would be there with a couple of times. What's your next to watch? What's something that I want to talk to you about that's really important? Something that's been in my heart. And he of the purpose to share the gospel with them and introduce the thing to Jesus for the first time. And to be friends. To be that friend. Like the Bible speaking to us. So, listen to this story. Listen to how these Christmas scenes in verse 13. This is his honest before God's return.
Thank you.